The final judgment discourse of Jesus in Matthew chapter 25 shows us that whatever we do to our neighbors, especially to the least of them, is done to God. Here in this discourse, we see the Son of Man coming as King to his royal throne, and the people of our nations gathered before him. He divides them into two groups, just as separate the sheep from the goats. He will put the right people on his line, and he will say to them, "Here's what he said. Come, you that are blessed by my Father. Come and search the kingdom which has been prepared for you ever since the creation of the world. I was hungry, and you fed me. Thirsty, and you gave me a drink. I was a stranger, and you received me in your homes. Naked, and you clothed me. I was sick, and you took care of me. In prison, and you visited me." The righteous then asked him, "When, Lord, did we ever see you hungry and weak, or thirsty and give you drink? When did we ever see you a stranger and welcome you in our home, or naked and love you? When did we ever see you sick or in prison and visit you?" The king shall reply, "O behold, I tell you, whenever you do this for one of the least important of these brothers of mine, you did it for me." And brothers there would refer to neighbors. I repeat, I tell you, whenever you do this for one of the least important of his brothers of mine, the poorest of the poor, the most clear of all, you did it for me. We should put, therefore, God himself as our neighbor. Then Jesus continued to say, "On the other hand, whenever one refuses to do this, he refuses to do it to God." We are all Filipinos, and therefore, likely have a large social circle of friends and family. Look at us here today in this confession. We have more neighbors who are even strangers to us than our own. Bishops, we are not the names of all around here. Many people whose names have no connection to an office, to a classmate, to a church, or postmate, are calling for help. We would be limiting our generosity otherwise. The only other way to reach out to our neighbors is to volunteer. So the first word of your theme, volunteers. We are used to acting when we are called upon to act, and to respond by need to the end of something. We must remember those who do not know how to call, or worse still, are afraid. I wish to stress that volunteerism is seeking out where one might be needed without being asked and without asking anything in return. I repeat, we must remember those who do not know how to call or worse still are afraid to call out. I wish to stress that volunteerism is seeking out where one might be needed without being asked and without asking anything in return. Service of Christ. In this regard, I must confess that we are now entering the expertise of my wife, her sister Gigi. She's there in the area. I often talk to people about answering the call to service and duty. People answer in different ways, whether running for office or becoming a public servant. I have done these things, but to see out voices of help that are not often heard and find where one might be needed. This is your sister Gigi. She had been known for a long time and advocate of volunteerism. For 15 years, from 1986 to 2001, she was the director of the National Volunteer Service Coordinating Agency, a government agency under the National Economic and Development Authority. This meant, among other things, organizing national and regional conferences for volunteers for many, many years. even when she was no longer director. She retired from service. She continued to help the aged by creating several events. She became an active member and an officer of the International Association of Volunteer Effort. And the Association of more important than ecology, is a teacher. She still holds his place. Sometimes she will be she's one of the first volunteers to be trained as a corporate specialist and guardian advocate for children with the law who are brought into the courts. The program was called to search to correct and improve the treatment of our children in conflict with the law, where our family funds to pay the people that need to do. Her agency is among many other things to fill gaps in the many important services of government platform, promises to our country, which our country cannot always do because of one reason or another lack of funds. The agency is central ground, the remaining of the country is a threat or killing its forces. The challenge of voluntarism, my dear brothers, in especially in relation to our neighbors, is stronger on the heights of Columbus. Is one of us nice. This challenge comes most strongly from the cardinal principles of the order itself, charity, fraternity, and patriotism. A neighbor or neighbors is the fundamental focus of these principles, especially the principle of charity, which is a love of neighbor, as Jesus teaches, as in Matthew and reiterated in Mark, is the second greatest command. Brothers, we are all the leaders of communities and beacons of faith. And yet, if not every day, we challenge ourselves to do better, to live better, to fulfill our duty to God, our country, and our family with God. At this convention, we must remind ourselves not to pursue this excellence of faith and duty on our own. We must do it together. We must remind ourselves that we cannot wait and something. We must oftentimes go out and look for help ourselves. We challenge ourselves to be greater things, but greatness is not in high-sounding positions or large acts of kindness or generosity. For the Knights of Columbus, or each one of us, there are many calls. There are many needs. For instance, the most immediate call and needs are what we see today. As elections in our country draw near, we hear speeches about everyone's needs, about everyone's promises, how to fix the country, etc., etc. But we know all about big talk and big dreams, and big accusations, and big announcements for fixing things. We all know about our people power, our going to the streets in camaraderie and outreach. This was 25 years ago. We were reminded of our people power a little less than a year, when President Corazon Aquino passed away. There were songs about how proud we were to be Filipino. We do not lose the spirit of people power because we have not taken the streets. We might lose the people power when we do not know how to live it every day and we stand beside our country and our neighbors without the lives of TV cameras or the threats of tanks. These calls and needs are in our immediate lives. They are in our barracks. And in the faces that we see in the streets every day. In these elections, let us mobilize our efforts to help our electorate form a principled judgment and exercise faithfully their sacred right of suffrage, their weapon to uphold their sovereign authority, to ensure that those elected will be men of integrity, honesty, humility, and competence, men whose commitment only public trust character of this office is pure and genuine. As I said, helping our neighbors is a core value in the cardinal principles of our order. It follows then that the order in the Philippines through the three jurisdictions and the councils under each must have a continuing plan of action and that will make them truly dynamic and aggressive in the pursuit and enhancement of its various programs and activities, church, civic, youth, community, government, patriotic, etc. For instance, we have to be in the forefront, in the fight to protect the life of the unborn and of conception, and to preserve the institutions of marriage and the family. In the fight for justice and truth, in the fight to empower the poor and the marginalized, in the fight to preserve Mother Earth, which is now threatened because of climate change, in the fight against drug and corruption, in the fight against dangerous drugs and gambling, all forms of evil that degrade man and society. Let us all be active instruments in promoting a civilization. We can do that only by doing all this. As I have said in many times, as an ordinary KC member, then as Grand Line, District Deputy, and State Advocate, the KC must mean in the larger, wider, and deeper sense, not just Knights of Columbus, but Knights of Christ. Let us then take full advantage of this 8th Convention, and thereafter, remain unceasing in living the spirit of his faith, voluntarism, neighbors, helping neighbors. Let us make it our everyday people power. Thank you and God bless us all.